This is our gold band. Predominantly these folks, many of them have been with us from the very, very beginning. We're 12 years old this year, and we couldn't be more thrilled to be a part of the New Horizons programs that you see across the nation that have bands and orchestras and even choirs with them. The piece that we're going to open our performance with is called El Choclo. This is a whole compilation of Argentinian tangos. Having been to Argentina myself, I know those people don't sleep. They tango at night. And I remember being on a very long flight. All I could think about was just getting to the hotel. When I arrived, they picked me up at 9, and they said, okay, now we're going to go to a club, and then we'll have dinner at 11, and then we'll tango. I got home at 5:30. They'd made special arrangements for me to have this world-renowned tango teacher. It was not pretty. I'm sure he was thinking, who is this dumb, clumsy broad from Cleveland? I mean, it was terrible. But this is a wonderful piece, and it really challenges us in the expanses of the rhythm. I would say tonight, you know, one of the unique things about working with a New Horizons band is that you're with adults. And I tell you, they serve as inspiration to myself and my students as well. They live their lives with such passion and commitment, and I admire and I remember every day their lifelong learning commitment. And I want to brag about it a little bit before we play our first tune. You know, in our New Horizons Orchestra, we have a couple of music teachers that are learning how to play strings for the very first time because their assignment changed at their schools. Mm. I am proud that our dear euphonist back there, Mr. Frank Stanek, is going to be a music performance major at Ashland University next semester. He's always wanted to have a good day. I mean, that is just the coolest thing. He's retired, and he's always wanted that music performance degree, so he auditioned, and now he's a student. How cool is that? So it's those types of stories that really touch me and remind me to keep on pushing and moving forward, because they're living their lives with meaning as a result of their involvement in the arts and so, so many other things. So, we'll begin with El Choclo. Thank you. Doug back there on that trumpet. Wow. Our next selection is one movement out of an original orchestral work by Eldar that was entitled, as you can see from your program, The Enigma Variations. He got an inspiration. He thought it might be fun that he would write a piece, and each variation would be dedicated to a different friend of his, and each movement would be reflective of that friend's personality or the relationship that he had with that individual. He's never really let on what the inspiration for the main theme, the Enigma theme, is. However, each of these variations he's dedicated to important people in his life and tells us a little bit more about them. Perhaps the most popular of all the variations is the Nimrod variation, and he wrote that for his very best friend. And it really does, although the name doesn't necessarily reflect it, it does reflect in the music just a really strong, heartfelt, a supportive friend relationship that they did have together. And he said, you know, I wrote this piece and I called it Nimrod because you're a Nimrod. It's like, okay. But it's really quite a lovely work. It's a challenge for us because of the style and the tempo, but I think you're going to enjoy it as much as we do. The beauty of this music in this time of year calls us to think about some of our band members that are not able to be with us this evening, either because they're ill or we've lost a band member this past fall, Mr. Bob Knack. We called him Mr. Treble Clef Bob. We loved him very, very much, and he's not here with us this evening, but he's certainly here in our hearts. He was a dedicated band member for many, many years, and his dear wife, Alberta, is with us tonight playing oboe. So I can't help but think of him when we play some beautiful music together, because he was so committed to what we do in music making, and he's certainly in our hearts this evening. So, Nimrod by Elgar.
Thank you.
evening. I just want to thank you again for coming out on this snowy evening. We give one concert each semester, and we're always looking for new members, so if you're thinking about maybe playing an instrument, give us a call. We'd be happy to have you join us in January. We're going to close this evening's performance with a wonderful medley from Porgy and Bess. Stay warm, have a wonderful holiday, and thanks again for your support. So here we are, the last tune of the night. Porgy and Bess, originally composed by George Gershwin. He described it as a folk opera, at least that's what he wanted it to be. And I know that most of you, when you hear the word opera, you already start falling asleep, and that's okay. But this is going to be a very, very different type of opera tonight. If you know anything about the music of George Gershwin, you know you're going to hear a lot of jazzy sounds, a lot of bluesy sounds, and I think it's going to be something that you're not going to expect. It's a great tune, they're playing it well, and here it is, the last tune of the night, Porgy and Bess.